Hello, and welcome to Hints and Tips.
We have been collecting traffic information for over a decade now. This gives us an advantage to predict traffic flow and estimated time of arrival for routing.
When we use the traffic API, there are two APIs that we have to consider. First, we have the traffic incidents API. This one will give us events happening on the road. As a service API, you can use it to fetch events in a bounding box, that is an area in the map, but also it is used internally by the SDK to display incidents as a map layer. The second one is the traffic flow. This one gives us how fast or slow a road or street segment's doing. For example, we can learn if traffic is heavy in comparison to the average, or is it going at a normal speed. The SDKs are also using the traffic flow as a map layer, but we can always get the information surrounding a location using the Flow Segment Data API. In the SDK for web, we have to create a configuration object to create map layers. So, with this in mind, we need a configuration file for the map incidents tier layer and another one for the traffic flow tier layer. In these ones, we set the tile style if we want the icons for the incidents or not, etc. Click on the link below for more information on this. Adding a traffic layer on your map can be helpful if you are helping your users to navigate visually in real time.
Again, thank you for watching, and if you like these videos, smash that like button. Happy mapping!